Every science has got its beauty. Ayurveda has its too. Every science has got its limitation. Ayurveda has its also. The bitter truth is, we are far behind our limitations. Sometimes it becomes necessary to unlearn certain things to understand Ayurveda in its purest form. I feel if you try to figure out the blueprint of the creation, the anatomy will be Panchamahabhuta and the law behind the physiology is Karana Karya Siddhanta. Close your eyes, take your time. Just try to imagine one single object which does not belong to Panchamahabhuta. Be sure no one can destroy Ayurveda, still this Panchabhautika earth exists. Bhut, the literal meaning itself, is which exists always. Even the Brahma has not written Ayurveda, but he remembered it. Brahma Smritva Ayurveda. If we dilute the concept, slowly it may fade away from the human usage. But someone later who is eager wants to learn the real truth behind the working anatomy and physiology of this world has to end up realizing the concept of Ayurveda. So mind it clearly, it is not for the sake of Ayurveda we have to keep it alive. It is for humankind. It is for our brothers and sisters. It is for our own family we have to keep Ayurveda alive. There is only one way to keep Ayurveda alive is to understand it in its purest form. If we remove the cover religion from ancient Indian text, we can realize it is full of science. And the only science existing today in an applied form is Ayurveda. I always felt we are like a safe boat in a huge ship. No one will look for you until everything going fine. And when it hits a rock or when it suffers a storm, people run for their life chasing this small safe boat, which Ayurveda witnessed in recent pandemics. I feel this generation who carries Ayurveda is like this safe boat. We have a bigger responsibility of taking Ayurveda to next generation without diluting it. Never make the mistake of comparing Ayurveda with modern science, because both science entirely travels in a different path. We have to stick on with our concept and stand by that. And if needed, simplify it and teach the concept to your patients. It may take a while to get some basic understanding. And once that happens, then it is fun to apply the concept. You can behave like a fortune teller and predict the pathophysiology and guide patients towards their wellness. You can bend the law of Ayurveda if you have tasted the essence of it. I never forget this statement from my teacher. When I asked him, "My friends who studied along with me is earning good and I am still depending on my parents for basic things." He smiled and replied, "If you want to practice Ayurveda, you have to struggle. Once you start practicing Ayurveda after understanding it, it will not only bring you patients, it will not only give you money, but the knowledge will give you confidence, strength, and courage in your life. Because Ayurveda is not just a medical science, it is a life science."